Morning, guys. Saturday, and I am here specifically, but not exclusively, to listen to my new record. It turned up yesterday, Crime of the Century, original master recording. So I had to get this from the US, particularly rare now. Some Mobile Fidelity Sound Lab recording, so I'm super chuffed to be in here today and having a listen to this. So there's not necessarily any reviewing, or I mean there'll be a fair amount of product, but yeah, bit of a different video today. I'm gonna listen to this, let you know what I think. I grew up with Supertramp. When I say I grew up with them, I'm too young to sort of have been around when they were around, but my parents and people around them were fans, so you know, I was constantly hearing them, so they've kind of been a part of my musical experience across my whole life, which is, you know, different to music that comes and goes, or you know, sort of current bands or bands that come out as you're growing up, you know, and I think it holds a different place in your life as well. So something like this kind of is kind of smeared quite broadly across my whole life, whereas there'll be powerful spikes of bands that come out and you know, during periods of life, and that's how I associate music with my emotions. It is each time I listen to something or hear something, that it takes me to that place. Not to be super weird about it, but that's my that's how I get on with music. I it just kind of makes me remember stuff. It makes me, you know, and that's good and bad, you know. There's tracks that I don't go anywhere near because they just remind me of rubbish bits, you know, or they might just be rubbish themselves. But this one is, as a whole, is quite happy for me. Crime of the Century, and all of their other sort of albums from earlier on as well. Crisis, What Crisis? And there's particular tracks as well. Fool's Overture from Even in the Quietest Moments, I think that's that album. Yeah, it's just incredible. Brilliant track. Anyway, that's not on this, and I haven't got that. And to get that in, you know, the Mobile Fidelity Sound Lab recording is particularly difficult. So yeah, I was made up when this turned up, and it's actually in incredible condition. The record itself is in better condition than the binder, you know. So I don't know how well that's gonna focus, but it's still nice and glossy. It doesn't look like it's been rubbed with a dog, you know. It's I'm really looking forward to it. Hopefully it doesn't sound rubbish. Yeah, so when I say not exclusively, that's pretty much the only reason I'm here today. I want to listen to that. My wife, Lottie, bless her, she wanted me to go paddle boarding with her. I had a dramatic incident with a kayak years ago, so I don't go near them things anymore. So I've been avoiding that like the plague. So she's not too happy with me at the moment, but this will take the edge off, I think. Is that not how it works? Yeah, anyway, so another reason is we've got a system on at the moment that we're running in for somebody quite special. So I'll probably discuss that in its own individual video, but we're putting some hours on a system for somebody who was one of those spikes with me as I was growing up. So yeah. It's quite mind-blowing, actually, but yeah. And what that has done is that's brought in a set of Evoke 30s, which we haven't had in here before. We've had every other Evoke other than the 30. Because I somewhat considered it a stepping stone between the 20 and the 50, it's not there's a reason it exists, and it's very, very apparent. So I'm going to probably, as part of what I'm here to do today, I'm going to listen to this. But whilst I listen to this, there'll be an element of me hearing this, because I don't necessarily critically listen to music that I like. But whilst I'm hearing this album today and enjoying it, I'm going to try and keep a non-biased opinion because of the music that's being played, of the Evoke 30. Yeah, don't expect a bad review. It's since the moment it's been put in, its characteristics are different from any of the other Evokes. But more on that later on, and in a different video. It's not for this video. So mostly today will be about Supertramp, and I will be putting sound in the video. I will be recording a little bit. I know that you can't portray that via YouTube, but if I try a little bit, you know, you get a bit more than what you would usually get from most people's smartphones. I understand that. And other sort of reviewers and hi-fi people's opinion of recording music for the enjoyment of others doesn't really matter to me. So keep it to yourself, or go and watch one of their videos. Yeah, slightly different one today. I'm not going to compare it digitally. I know this album like the back of my hands. I'll know whether it's good or not. So, also, not to keep going on, our X2 has just received the Cadenza Black cartridge. We're using the V10, which is part of the system that's going out next week. The Hegel V10 phono stage, which we've set up alongside that cartridge. So it should, and I'm hoping that it'll be the sort of best vinyl replay that I've heard personally in here, because it's about as far as up the upgrade path as I've been. So yeah, I'll let you know about that, and the fact that we're now an Autophone Centre of Excellence as well. So we have all of the lines here, and a fair amount of the knowledge. You know, I'm not an Autophone genius at the moment, and none of us are, but we will get there. So help and warranty from products that you've bought from ours, things like that, they'll all be, you know, we're now just a you know, at the top of the ladder, so we can help out with that. Yeah. Let's play some music, let's listen to some speakers, and let's try and make two or three videos out of this one morning, which will make it worth my while. See you over there. I'm not going to dust this off because it is in immaculate condition, and I'm finding lately that my brush does more harm than good, so I need to figure out what everyone else is doing to clean their records, really.
So that's about 2 or 3 hours now. This is my third time around, and I've listened to a Donna Summer on the radio. One of the all-time greats, a massive favourite of mine. Anyway, I've put in, as you may have seen, I've eaten some pasta, and I've put in the 60i's, the console 60i's, because the Evoke 30s have got to go, so we can't keep them in here, unfortunately. We'll get a set. If you've seen the review that I've just done, which probably is going to be out after this video, not this one, so you won't have seen it. I just wheeled the 60s in because why not? You know, this album's so sort of dynamic, and there's plenty of crescendos, and I'm a little bit over the moon at the minute, I'm feeling a little bit strange, because this was one of my all-time favourite albums. I've had it throughout my whole life, in some shape or form. I had it on cassette. I've never had it on vinyl, actually. But CDs and various forms and Tidal, it's always in my download. So yeah, and hearing it as I've heard it today is the best I've ever heard it. So yeah, strange one for me. Like I say, music and hi-fi and car audio have always been huge passions of mine, and it's weirdly coming together today. So yeah, anyway, that's the end of that. The I must say, the 60i's, the Hegel H390, the V10 phono stage, the X2 with the Cadenza Black on there. I don't think there's a piece in that system as it sits right now that I would ever change. I think it's brilliant. That system, of course, it gets rotated, so there's always various stuff that's on there. But this one, as it sits now, even the way it looks, to be fair, the gloss black and satin 60i's, and then the satin black of everything else, and then the satin black sideboard with the glass top, and then our Maxell print behind it is, yeah. What a lovely Saturday morning. Yeah, like I say, bit of a different one, just a little bit of my goings on a Saturday morning. It's not every Saturday morning I get to do this. So a lot of sort of commitments. Once probably a month I get to just wind down, and it brings me back to the whys and whats and wheres of what we do here and what I do, you know, in my life. So yeah, great stuff. Look out for the other videos that I've done today. I've finished our Autophon video today. We're now an Autophon Centre of Excellence, which is great news for us. And I cheekily took the liberty to review the Evoke 30s whilst we were putting some hours on them for our client, who is a massive deal to me and the people that work in here. And hopefully there's no red tape and we can tell you who that is and maybe show you the installation of the system once we've done it. All right, guys, I'm Carl. This is Studio In Car and Studio Hi-Fi. All right, take it easy.